Film Companion gets you your film fix. Hit the bell icon and subscribe to get notified every time we drop a new video.
Anurag, lyrics de.
Main beats deta hu.
Lyrics de. Kya kya bolu?
Nahi, lyrics to Anupama ji dengi na.
Lyrics to hamari yahi hai ki if you like this video, yeah, you like this interview, like this chat, subscribe to Film Companion.
Such a difficult line to score. Addish lag raha hai pura.
हाँ अच्छा है ना, जिंगल है।
आपको अगर हमारा वीडियो पसंद आया, प्लीज सब्सक्राइब टू फिल्म कंपेनियन।
Anurag, Pritam, welcome to Film Companion. I'm so happy to get the both of you together. And I want to start first of all by thanking you for all the lovely, lovely music you have given us over the last, 19, 20, 20 plus years, including your latest Ludo. When I listen to Hardam Hamdam or Abad Barbad, like, kano ko thoda sa sukoon mil jata hai. So thank you. Really, thank you for that. This is, of course, your fifth collaboration together. And I was just wondering, I'm fascinated by artistic collaborations that endure, that what is it like for two people, for two artists to work with each other again and again and continue to inspire each other. And I was wondering, this is the fifth, the last one, Jagga Jasoos, was in a sense your magnum opus. Last I read, it had 29 songs. Is that correct? 29?
Maybe more, because the entire film had songs, just
correct.
Music, like if you count small, everything was music.
Everything was music, right?
Yeah, the whole expression was music.
Absolutely. So that film was also your most experimental, the way you used music, what you did, the tunes, the influences you had from where to where, from Bengali to Africa. And when that film didn't work, did that put pressure on you both to be more conservative with Ludo?
But I don't think Ludo music is conservative, and we're still new.
It is. Like I said, mere ko to bahut sukoon mila.
Actually, Anurag, brief was also in Ludo that, like you said, jo sukoon wala baat hai na, he wanted, initial brief was that ki mitha, ekdam mithas wala jo gaane hota hai. वैसे विल गो इन दैट अप्रोच सो दैट वाज द अप्रोच ओनली सो इफ यू सी ऑल द सॉन्ग्स इन लूडो हैज अ सर्टेन सेंस ऑफ दैट मिठास एंड वर्ड्स वाइज वेरी इट्स नॉट अ इट्स वेरी पोएटिक ऑल द लिरिक्स इफ यू सी इट्स वेरी थॉट अबाउट दैट तो अनुराग इज एक्सपर्ट इन ऑल दिस थिंग्स सो I totally depend on him when it comes to lyrics.
Yeah,
it's extremely thought about the lyrics, and it has its old world charm. That's what Anurag also wanted, to keep that old world charm in a new packaging. Even while doing background, it's very meetha. The entire background is very, very meetha. The entire approach is very meetha. But it actually, the upper texture of the film is not like that,
right?
So it's kind of contradicting each other.
Yeah.
So basically, the whole idea was to get that emotions out from the back and get it forward. That usiliye aisa film mein actually gaana hota hi nahi normally. Oh, Anurag bol ke aisa film mein alag type of gaana hota tha, maybe one theme, central theme song and all. Which would have come back all the time and want a kind of like a background music. The background theme, which also holds the film, is a very sweet kind of theme. It's not a very like a Tarantino approach where it's very edgy, and it's not like that. It's very, very, very sweet. The entire thing is very sweet.
Pritam, you had, when we talked a couple of years ago, you had told me that Anurag and Imtiaz are the two directors who have the music sense to know from a few notes what will make a good song. So I want the two of you to tell me, what is your working process? I mean, do you hum a few notes to Anurag? Anurag, do you give him a brief? How do you two actually make a song like Hamdam Hardam?
Pritam, you say.
You start.
You start.
You're the director. You start.
Are you start? Are
you start? You start.
नहीं नहीं पीतम पी.
बोला बोला तू बोल.
सही तू बोल तू बोल.
See, I in the last interview also I told you that Anurag does have this, like, there are few directors whom I can actually hammer even in a very scratch level.
Yeah.
So उसमें क्या होता है ना, मेरा advantage ये होता है कि गिटार में डाडा करके इंसुला में I can present a lot more approach, whereas to do a scratch lyrics and make a track or you know kind of have a scratch lyrics into it and all these things. So that's the advantage is that I can play him a lot of things. Like in one sitting, I remember we went out to Leela, na? Leela, that hotel is Leela, na?
I don't know which one you're talking about. Which sitting?
Are we went to that hotel, na? In that, what is that hotel?
Some hotel, no, yeah. So now we are
okay. So, usme hum log aise kiya tha ek din. I at one stretch I played in some 20-25 songs. So that is only possible if you can play. You know, if you put lyrics, if you put make a scratch, you can't play so many options.
Correct.
So, so that's one advantage with Anurag. And also another advantage is like lyrically he's very strong. So I can completely depend ki kuch aa jayega lyrically isme.
Because your Hindi is not very good.
My Hindi is not very good. my sense of lyrics is totally on the phonetics.
Right.
So sometimes I tend to like things which sounds very good, you know, but might not be meaning so nice, you know.
Yeah.
So, yeah. But I have always reacted to lyrics on phonetics.
Anurag, you always said that Pritam is like one of the backbone elements of your cinema. So do you start thinking of the soundscape while you're writing? Are you thinking then that this is what Pritam's going to be able to do here, this is what he can do there?
I would say when I start writing it, and there's always a template, you know, in my head, the music template. I cannot think without music in my head or something playing in the background or my playlist. I have to have a template. So somehow that template conveys into the, you know, I have to convey it to Pritam. And it takes, maybe the template changes by the time we make the music. But yeah, whenever I have some subject or any story, so halfway through I narrate to Pritam. I don't finish the script. And then the parallel process starts. The music and the scripting, you know, happens parallelly. And Pritam also doesn't know in the beginning of the film when I narrate how many songs will be there. We're just making songs and, you know, because there are still two templates we need to attempt. You know, we have been trying to do it in film, you know, which is we are postponing since Jagga, there's another. So now we'll try to attempt it in our next film.
We have been trying.
We are trying. There's one favorite genre we both want to try stuff, but maybe next film. And we couldn't do it in this film because this demand was something else. Yeah, it happens. Anu, it साथ साथ में चलता है दोनों. अगर गाना फिर प्रीतम कुछ बजाता है तो कुछ गाना सुन के फिर मैं काम करता हूँ. फिर ऐसे करते करते हो जाता है. तो कब ना प्रोसेस कब शुरू होता है खत्म होता है मुझे पता नहीं. एंड प्रोसेस एक्चुअली शुरू होता है, यू नो व्हाट हैपेंस इज प्रीतम व्हेन आई नरेट, फॉर एग्जांपल आई गिव यू एग्जांपल ऑफ लूडो, बिकॉज व्हेन योर लास्ट फिल्म फेल्स, नो जग्गा फेल्ड, इट वाज वेरी टफ टू डिसाइड व्हाट नेक्स्ट नाउ. सो आई हैड जस्ट रिटन स्क्रिप्ट्स आफ्टर स्क्रिप्ट्स आफ्टर स्क्रिप्ट, आई not really knowing one where which direction to go.
I'll just cut you here. I hate the term Jagga failed because I think
it's not fail, not fail.
It's a very good film. It failed.
And you know, Pritam, I set love that. I really love that. And I
no, you start.
People will discover it, Anurag. They will. It has
nice discovering.
It has such whimsy. It has such beauty in it. It's a lovely film.
No, it's. Yeah. It's so heartening because now also now sometimes I go and check hashtag Jagga Jasus and I still get
reviews. I am after Anurag, ki you have to make a sequel or whatever. That is a genre nobody does in and it's not intelligently thought out that, see, I stammer myself. So and I don't stammer while singing. So intelligently thought out ki he sings because he stammers. And right, so he has actually thought out a world. Yeah. I am after him. I am after him to make a sequel to Metro also. He doesn't listen to me from when I've been telling to make a sequel to Metro. And Jagga, so he should make one sequel for sure.
I second that. I think so too. Sequel to Jagga. Please, continue with your answer.
So the one of the skit which I narrated was also sequel of Metro. And there was one more skit. And there was Ludo. And I asked Pritam that I don't know which one to make. So I bounced my skit to him. And then he loved Ludo instantly. I was not sure whether he made the right choice. Then Tani, my wife, gave the same stamp, same choice. You know, Ludo is the film you should go for. So there it is. I started making Ludo.
Pritam, bolna.
I knew musically
yeah.
Ludo was not the thing which a musician will go for it, because obviously Ludo ka scope is not there.
Yeah.
But when he narrated Ludo, that time I felt ki yaar isme to kuch hai, nayapan hai, kuch alag hai. So I felt very nice about it. So, and I said, nahi wo kar le, that was his third choice. And then Tani also said, so he went with Ludo.
But
sorry, Anupama, going back to your previous question, sorry. Jaise kuch gaane hote hai na, Pritam ke, jaise for example, a lot of songs which me and Pritam have made earlier, I'm not able to use, main rakh deta hun side mein, Pritam. Because those are timeless songs. Even if I use it after 10 years also, it will be fresh.
I think, and so.
Yeah. So there
you
are
know,
few songs.
You know, songs like Phir Le Aaya Dil or In The Know, it's not a song bound, it's not a trendy song. That song will hit you and touch your heart no matter when that comes out. I mean, these are timeless songs, and that's really what the current music doesn't have. It doesn't have shelf life. That is the tragedy. But I will ask you about that later. Tell me, Siddharth Roy Kapoor, you were speaking about Metro. Siddharth Roy Kapoor told my colleague Mohini that the narration for Life in a Metro was one of the best he's ever had, because the two of you gave it together and you were narrating and you were playing music. Can you describe this scene to me, please?
Yeah, that's true.
I'll tell you the truth, Anupama, I can say, because I was not ready with the script. It was a drama I had to put up in front of UTV, Siddharth and Ronnie. So then what happened was, I thought I'll kill time and I'll... So I was only ready with half of the script. So I will narrate and then Pritam will play one song. And Pritam was also not ready with 2-3 songs, or all the songs. So first half went smoothly. All the songs were ready. And Pritam was not ready with the second half. I started narrating the second half. Even I was not ready with the second half. I was just spinning yarn. I was narrating. And then Pritam, I said, Pritam, then that song comes. And Pritam is asking me in Bengali, Kungan, ki. So and then I told Pritam, that one. And then Pritam made some funny lyrics. It was hilarious. Because Pritam, whatever he loves, and I remember that lyrics he said, Baate kuch ankaisi song he sang. And I still remember what he sang there. Dalchini. Tumi ho Maldini, Tumi ho Tata, Mona Lisa, something like that, he said. So he made the whole song out of football names, food names, artist, painter.
Regular? Do you both regularly do script narrations together?
No.
No?
No. Metro was a thing. Yeah. Metro was one of that. Narration happened with music, because music was placed and also some songs were cracked in Metro. And Alvida especially had the live thing of Alvida was very impactful all the time. I had a vibe to it all the time. I remember because Alvida I had cracked earlier and I had the song in the institute days. Every party, I had to play Alvida to everybody. That was the thing. So, in fact, I got my first film because of Alvida, as in Raju. I used to do a lot of ads with Raju, and he used to, in the ads, in the break, I once played Alvida to him. So he was really mad after Alvida. He really liked Alvida. Then he introduced me to Sanjay for Alvida. Then when I was doing Metro, I called up Raju and saying, I'm using Alvida here. So Alvida was a song. So that song was fixed because that song was from earlier. And so the overall impact was there. In fact, I remember with entire Sid and everybody, the whole team, we even played the Barfi song in guitar. We had some, we had a stock of around...
Yeah, Barfi also happened like that. Yes, yes, yes.
10, 12 songs we had in stock. In fact, we had to delay Barfi by 2 months to we played all the songs in guitar. Remember that in the background?
Release,
we had to delay, yeah. So,
both of you, Pritam, Anurag, both of you have reputations in the film industry of being agents of chaos. Okay. I think those lyrics from your song, Aflatoon from Jagga Jasus, can apply to you. You know, naughty si smile, atrangi hai, sar phira par banda hoshiyar. That's definitely the two of you. Tell me, how do two inherently disorganized people work together?
I'm organized. Yes. No, Pritam is also organized. But you know what the problem? No, me and Pritam both have this common problem. People have this, people think that I don't have any script. And for you also know it's not possible. When you're writing a film like Metro or a film like Ludo, scripts are always there. But the problem is, you know what, I'll talk about myself, Pritam will talk about his problem. So what happens is, script is ready. And then, but I don't commit to the scene till the last moment. Wo gaadi pe jaate jaate, fir baad mein set pe jaake kuch naya hota hai. So wo last moment tak main commit nahi karta. So I don't give my actors a script. I want them to come empty, you know, with empty slate, and we'll improvise and we'll do things like that. But scripts are always there. With Pritam also, I think the problem is the same. Is he keeps working and on his song till the last moment, till the time he can.
My point is simple. The problem is, once the song goes out of your hand, then it's no longer yours. So you can't do anything. No? So you have to, like, I'll take a call when you need it. When you don't need it, why ask for me 1 month before? The thing is, for example, Hardam Hamdam, I have around 9 orchestrations ready. Okay, mm-hmm. I was parallelly mixing four. I was mixing them. So ultimately, Anurag went to this, so in his own... he said, no, I want that only which I shot with. So ultimately, we went with the first one only. But I had. So I was keeping my options open. So, jab enai tab main de dunga. But I work on multiple things. So if you don't need it, don't take it from me. It's there. My thing is that, abhi kya hua? Abhi log has started bill following on me. But everything, the gun is put on my shoulder because it's very convincing and easy to believe. So gun is put on. Inke liye late ho gaya, abhi kya karu? Like, even this, like anything, if it gets delayed for promo, if it gets delayed for anything, ultimately sab alcohol kar. आप डिले करो मैं बोला मेरा कब का पहुंच गया मास्टर आप देखो आपके लिए उधर से वो एंड से डिले हो रहा है बट वो फर्स्ट The thing will be entire bill will be furrowed on me first, so that I've got used to it.
But when you two work together, you don't, matlab, you're each other's chaos. Ki Anurag's working until the shot is canned, you are working until the master is left. This you don't drive each other crazy.
Chota mota jhagda wari ki nahi, we don't drive, we completely understand each other's process. It never happened.
Kabhi ye nahi hota ki yaar ab de do, matlab us koi badi ladai kabhi nahi hoti.
नहीं मैं तो बिना गाने के भी गाना शूट कर लेता हूँ खुशी खुशी
अरे ये तो ये ही कॉल्ड अप ड्यूरिंग मेट्रो ही कॉल्ड मी अप एंड सेइंग अरे वो अबाउट अलविदा ओनली तो सॉन्ग वाज नॉट सॉन्ग वाज ऑलरेडी था तो ही कॉल्ड अप से अरे वो गाना क्या था अलविदा अलविदा ये कल ट्यून बोल मुझे तो आई हैंड द होल सॉन्ग टू हिम बोले ओके 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 आई सेड व्हाट व्हाट या व्हाट्स हैपनिंग मैन व्हाई डू यू वांट टू हियर द सॉन्ग नहीं मैं अभी शूट कर रहा हूँ गाना मतलब उसने मैं बोला भी नहीं तो ही वाज सिंगिंग लाउड अलविदा अलविदा पुशिंग ट्रॉली
आर यू सीरियस यू डोंट टेक द सॉन्ग ऑन सेट टू शूट अ सॉन्ग
नो नो ही नो इन फैक्ट
वी शॉट
Barfi, I'll tell you one thing. Barfi, before because we had lot of stock of songs, we had Barfi around 10-11 songs, which were more always done and ready and all these things. So उसने आके एली बर्ड को बोला, अरे मैं गाने शूट नहीं किया विद द सॉन्ग, अभी बहुत डिफिकल्टी हो रहा है. फिर मैंने कहा जब फिल्म देख रहा है, व्हेन व्हेन द फिल्म वाज गोइंग ऑन, तो मुझे ऐसे ही लाइक कन्फेस कर रहे, अच्छा किया मैं गाने सुन के शूट नहीं किया, देख कर अतरंगी और अलग पिक्चराइजेशन लग रहा है.
So Anubhav, seriously, I was complaining, and I had, because whenever you're shooting, you're panning camera, you should have some tempo of the song in your head, right? I had, this will be the kind of song in my head, and this is how Pritam will compose. So I've shot the whole Barfi without any song, and I was complaining. I had a huge fight, not chota mota fight with Pritam, that I could have done a better job if the song was there. So then, during mixing, I realized it was being a disguise, actually. The song was looking better because there was no song.
और मुझे ये पहले नहीं बोला कि गाने चाहिए हुए, बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी हैड द सॉन्ग्स रेडी, तो बाद में मेरे को बोल रहे. और फिर वाइल तो आई गॉट, अरे तू बोला नहीं फिर ऐसे, बट वाइल थिंग द फिल्म बोल रहे अच्छा लग रहा है गाने सब.
अच्छा, और इन ऑल दीज इयर्स व्हाट यू बीन वर्किंग टुगेदर नाउ मोर देन 20 इयर्स, in all these years of knowing each other, there's never been like a big, big sort of disagreement, creative disagreement, where you both felt like, "Acha, this marriage is over."
No. No, never happened.
No.
How long? No, never. Nahin.
Kabhi? Aisa.
Not like that. No big argument. Small, chota argument. Just so for a couple of hours.
जो छोटे argument किस पे होते हैं?
बहुत चीजों में होती है, मतलब यू नो इट्स जस्ट. अच्छा, प्रीतम का प्रॉब्लम क्या है, प्रीतम का पता नहीं चलता है. मैं तो वोकल हूँ, मुझे गुस्सा आता है 2 सेकंड में बता, प्रीतम सल करता है. प्रीतम विल नॉट टॉक, ही विल जस्ट गो इनटू शेल एंड ही इज क्वाइटली जस्ट स्टार्ट मैसेजिंग समबडी एंड एज इफ ही इज देयर इज नोबडी इन द रूम. सो प्रीतम को समझ में नहीं आता, प्रीतम को अगर प्रीतम को गुस्सा आ रहा है समझने में थोड़ा टाइम लगता है. सो तब तक मेरा गुस्सा ठंडा हो जाता है.
सो इट वर्क्स परफेक्टली.
मेरा बहुत कम गुस्सा होता है, ऐसा नहीं होता.
विद
अनुराग आई डोंट फील दैट आई हैव एवर, बिकॉज़ ही अकोमोडेटेड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स एंड द फ्रीडम, द आल्सो द यू नो द कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन अस एंड हिज पैटर्न, आई kind of understand him, and he understands me very well. So I quite like the process is
quite. We talk funky. About life. We talk about life more than we talk about films. Actually, it's just really? Other stuff we talk. Yeah.
You know, at different points in your careers, both of you have had to deal with accusations of plagiarism. How did the two of you handle it? Did you speak to each other? Did you kind of lean on each other to handle all that comes with that?
Pritam can go with it. We all I will start with my thing. Yeah, you know what? Anupama, the first films which I did for Vishesh Film Bhatt Saab and all the other films. So I was really ashamed of all those things. You know what? Actually, kya hota uske baad, then I really started working hard on, you know, coming out with original stuff. But I do realize when, even if there's 2% of plagiarism charges on you, your 98% of your original work, you know, there's a question mark on it. I do realize that. And sometimes what happens is, for example, Barfi completely misfired. And misfired in a sense, because we were deliberately doing it, you know, and there was the shots which people said I plagiarized were most iconic scenes of cinema. You cannot, kitne aadmi the, you can't plagiarize, you know. And you show it and you know actually you're paying homage. You cannot do that. And we consciously selected those shots which are so visually iconic that anybody will see and say, that is what he's trying to do.
Hmm.
So that was the purpose, and that was, and a lot of people got it also actually. It hurt. But you know what? We all learned by our own mistakes. We learned.
So
I have a huge problem, I think, because of I was quite, you know, initially when there was a phase when, you know, I can't totally blame on the directors, producers that, there will be rights taken or whatever. That kind of phases also happened. And there has been phases, at that time, at that time.
It was accepted.
And it came kind of a storm to me when I realized it was too late. I remember going to Anurag that time also saying that, because it happened in around 2007, 2008, from 2004, 2005, 2006, 2007. Then I had, in fact, in multiple interviews, I have said sorry and said, listen, I know that it has happened. And this won't happen anymore. And what has happened that, what about 20, 25, 30 incidents which are has actually kind of affected me majorly. Till now, I have to carry that burden and move around, and it is unnecessary. Everything is doubted, and everything. I think that entire thing is बोलते हैं ना एक एक बूंद क्या बोलते हैं उसको
हाँ मतलब मछली एक मछली तालाब के अंदर what क्या phrase बोल रहा है
phrase I forgot that phrase it is not Hindi phrases है तो it has created a lot of problem I still have to carry that burden and roam around which is a very very heavy
I got maximum flag on Barfi and it's very baffling because Anupama aap yaad rakho ki agar mujhe lagta hai ki if we all are student of cinema hum log cinema lover hai aur hum log dekhte hain agar aap kisi cheez ko you know you're playing homage to an artist if you're not mentioning it is stealing but if you're talking about it and if you're saying this is where I'm getting inspired of I don't think it's stealing you see the making of Barfi which was before the film got released we mentioned our inspirations in the film and I was लेकिन आपको ऐसा लगता है कि मैंने सिनेरियो चेंज कर दिया आई टुक इन हॉलीवुड टेक्सास की स्टोरी एंड पुट इट इन बिहार का गांव एंड इट विल बिकम न्यू दैट इज स्टोरी स्टीलिंग इट बाय जस्ट चेंजिंग द सिनेरियो एंड चेंजिंग द कैरेक्टर एंड हैविंग द होल स्टोरी इंटैक्ट इज स्टीलिंग इफ यू आर बट यू शुड बी ब्रेव एनफ टू से नो आई हैव गॉट इंस्पायर्ड फ्रॉम देयर आई डोंट थिंक इट्स स्टीलिंग
टेल मी वेयर डिड यू टू मीट
long time back, when he used to stay in Kandivali, I used to stay in Mira Road. He worked on a television project together, I think. So that's how it started. 90s. We know each other when Pritam was... He was 40 kilo purani baat hai, Anupama ji. So, we were 40 kilo kam the, tab ki baat.
You connected immediately. You were friends instantly.
Absolutely. Slowly, slowly, all ho gaya. Pritam did lot of stuff for me in television. वहाँ पे भी दो तीन melody. Even those days, Pritam ने phone पे भी मुझे गाने बना के दिए कई बार. Remember Pritam? You were in Delhi and there was this title track we needed, and I played you the tune. Pritam used to come to Gemini Studio in the staircase. He'd come with guitar and play me some tune and. काम तब भी ऐसा ही होता था ऐसा नहीं कि टेलीविजन में भी यू नो वर्क डिफरेंट पे तब भी ऐसे ही काम होता था एंड प्रीतम हैज मेड सम ग्रेट टाइटल ट्रैक्स फॉर मी एंड कंपोजिशंस फॉर मी
सो अनुराग डू यू एवर फील इनसिक्योर अबाउट प्रीतम डू यू एवर थिंक ही माइट बी चीटिंग ऑन यू विद इम्तियाज कि कहीं बेटर सॉन्ग्स इम्तियाज को नहीं दे दे
नहीं आई डोंट थिंक दैट वे और इनफैक्ट क्या हो जाता है
दोनों का टेस्ट एकदम अलग है
एकदम आई लुक फॉरवर्ड टू एंड पॉलम का प्रीतम का सिटी में हमेशा पूछता हूँ कौन आ रहा है मेरे पहले सो इम्तियाज अच्छा चल रहा है उसे कम अर्ली वहां पे गप्पे मारेंगे सो प्रीतम्स एक्चुअली द म्यूजिक रूम बिकम्स आवर अड्डा मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम बिकॉज़ व्हेन द अदर डायरेक्टर्स आल्सो कम देयर एंड
या यू नो इन दिस करंट म्यूजिकल एनवायरनमेंट वेयर एवरीथिंग इज सो इंस्टेंट एंड सो डिस्पोजेबल I mean, films have multiple composers, songs have multiple singers. People don't know ki finally kaun sa final hoga. It's all very fluid. You know, anything changes anytime. How have the two of you maintained this creative partnership for so long?
I don't know. I think our taste of music also changed over the years. And we keep updating ourselves with the music. Pritam, what do you think? What is your answer?
Sorry, I didn't hear the question. My mind was somewhere. So,
I'm thinking of something else in the middle of my interview. Earth to Pritam, please. So the question was, Pritam, that in a music industry, which is right now, is very fickle and very fast changing, right? There's no more even the practice ki one film ka ek composer hoga, ek soundscape hoga, wo bhi nahi hai. Singers also doing multiple versions of songs. Songs have multiple singers. In such a fluid environment, how have you and Anurag maintain this relationship for more than 20 years?
I think it's maintained and it's well, and there's no problem. I think there's that inherent friendship and respect for each other's work. That's the thing has kind of held us together, and also taste, liking. I love his films. I love Anurag's films. I have immense respect for his talent, and ye film mein khud camera kiya hai, I have like incredible respect for his talent. So kind of, you know, I enjoy working with Anurag. So, and I hope it's the same with him also. So that's what and kind of look forward to Anurag's films as a audience also. I love Ludo. I loved Jagga. I loved Barfi. And I like all his films. So, in fact, I remember we used to stay in the same building earlier. Abhi I have shifted out. But dono building ke beech mein ek jhula hota tha, chota garden. And there's to be a jhula. He narrated me Gangster and Metro ek saath in that jhula. So I got super excited about Metro. Gangster, mujhe laga kyunki he narrated me in a linear way. Wo jo Gangster mein ke, when I saw the film, I said, tu kya narrate kiya aur tera screenplay jo hai, because it goes up and down. Na. I said, screenplay to is very exciting. But us time mein bola tha ki Metro is the super exciting, you should do Metro. But he was already shooting for Gangster that time. So wo ek like with family also like thoda sa ye hai hum so ek alag equation hai to uska it's not only a working relationship, it's correct. A lot of things. And also I've told this earlier also, he is younger to me, but he is wiser than me, a lot more wiser. Oh. Wisdom is higher. So I take a lot of advice from him. Lot of lot of life advice from him also.
ये life के discussion क्या होते हैं? Tell me please.
ऐसे interview होने चाहिए ताकि अपना नहीं तो कभी भी तारीफ करते नहीं ऐसे. Good Anupama. ऐसे तो मुंह पे कभी बोलेगा नहीं ऐसा होना चाहिए. Very good. I'm so happy. Thank you Anupama.
अच्छा but tell me ये life के discussions में क्या होता मतलब philosophy life what do you discuss?
मेरी बीवी के साथ झगड़ा होता है प्रीतम के पास आता है प्रीतम की बीवी के साथ प्रीतम को झगड़ा होता है मेरे पास आता है हम दोनों एक दूसरे की बीवी की शिकायत करते हैं और
नहीं इसके बिना
नहीं 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 लाइफ नहीं सब कुछ एक्चुअली सिर्फ लाइफ नहीं लाइफ पॉलिटिक्स सब कुछ दुनिया भर का हम लोग पता नहीं बेगानी शादी नहीं अब्दुल्ला दीवाना हम ऐसे ही अमेरिका के पॉलिटिक्स के बारे में डिस्कस करते हैं हमारा कोई लेना देना नहीं उससे बट बातें करते हैं
कुछ भी बातें करते हैं
कहीं पे भी
बातें का एंड होता है क्या एक बार स्टार्ट होता है तो
You know, tell me, I think that music is one of the great strengths of Indian cinema. I love that we have films with music. We have films with songs that people sing. But I think increasingly directors are becoming uncomfortable with lip sync songs. So more and more songs are now in the background, you know. And I feel afraid that are we moving towards a point where you might just have, you know, many, many films which are without songs. What do you think is the future of music in Hindi films?
See, the lip sync is in our system, you know, and it has been embedded through centuries, actually. All our art form, storytelling art form, performing art forms are singing. Aap Kathakali le lo, aap Majuma le lo, Nautanki le lo, aap any Bhavani Bhavai le lo, to wo apne system mein, isliye hamare filmon mein aaya.
Yeah.
Aur system se itne jaldi jayega bhi nahi. For example, I really missed lip syncing in Ludo. I keep telling Pritam Ludo mein, kyunki Ludo ka narrative aisa tha, aap lip sync nahi kar sakte. But I'll go back to lip sync again in next film because I was missing it. I think we should not shy away from it. It is our identity. The way world has developed taste for chicken tikka, they will develop taste for our singing films right. also.
They have already. Like they we are already. Going away from it. When the world knows that our films are
musical.
Musicals. Yeah. You know, like what they call musicals is our normal films. You know.
Yeah. उसके अंदर हमने एक musical बनाने गए. देखो हिम्मत तो हम लोग.
And that's what you know. Whenever they used to tell me that. अरे म्यूजिकल मतलब क्या कुछ 12 गाना है 13 गाना है सी द थिंग इज दैट्स वेस्टर्न म्यूजिकल में वो अगर 5-6-7 गाना होता तो वो लोग बोलता है ये म्यूजिकल है अपना तो वैसा तो ऑल द फिल्म्स आर म्यूजिकल बट एक्चुअली इफ यू कंपेयर विद वेस्ट इट्स व्हाट वी वर ट्राइंग टू डू वाज मोर ले मिज़राब व्हिच इज लाइक अ और लाइक अ ओपेरा थिंग व्हिच इज टोटली रिटन इन म्यूजिक
Yeah.
You know, like like the 80% of the thing is kind of drawn. The dialogues are in music, basically.
Correct. Well, listen, it was a great, ambitious, lovely film. And before I end, let's put in, Pritam, another plea for a sequel to Jagga Jassa.
Yes, absolutely. I tell him every time. Main to usko bola re tu kaam kar tu usko series bana ke kar le but kar le kaise bhi karke.
Series kitni achhi banegi na every episode will be
a new exactly.
Yeah. I say Anurag, आप इस पे थोड़ा सा फोकस कीजिए. This was so much fun.
Thank you so much.
Again, thank you for all the music and lots of fun.
आपको अगर हमारा वीडियो पसंद आया, please subscribe to Film Companion.
That was the best subscriber message we've ever got. Thank you.